الصلاة والسلام على الله. Seventh chapter of Salah. وله يعني لأبي سعيد الخدري عن عقبة بن عامر رضي الله تعالى عنه ثلاث ساعات كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ينهانا أن نصلي فيهن وأن نقبر فيهن موتانا حين تطلع الشمس بازغة حتى ترتفع وحين يقوم قائم الظهيرة حتى تزول الشمس وحين تتضيف الشمس للغروب. في رواية ضعيفة إلا يوم الجمعة. This hadith talks about other times where we're not supposed to start a salah, a prayer, without a cause. The first three times, so the first two times were when? After first prayer, right? And after asr, right? There are three more times. And some of these, three times, actually, like one of them is already included in these first two times. The first one, he says, these are 3 hours where we are prohibited to pray or to bury our dead. So these 3 hours have an additional prohibition where we should not bury someone who is dead during that time. The hadith says, حين تطلع الشمس بازغة حتى ترتفع. From the time of sunrise until it is way up. And the other hadith mentioned by length of a spear. So we said the first time was after Fajr prayer in general, right? After Fajr prayer in general. That's yesterday's hadith. But this one specifically mentions the time from sunrise until the sun is high up. That's about 15 minutes from the time of sunrise until it is higher up by about the length of a spear. So this time maybe is included in the first time mentioned yesterday, but it's in addition to that. And in this time we should not bury the dead, this time that's mentioned here. The other time is وَحِينَ يَقُومُ قَائِمُ الظَّهِيرَةِ وَحِينَ يَقُومُ قَائِمُ الظَّهِيرَةِ حَتَّى تَزُولَ الشَّمْسُ. And when the sun is in the middle of the sky, exactly at noon, when there's no shade. And he says قائم وحين يقوم قائم الظهيرة بمعنى أن الشمس تظهر وكأنها توقفت عن الحركة. Because it takes some time when the sun goes to the middle of the sky, you think that it stopped moving, but it starts then after that showing the going beyond, going towards the west, and then you start seeing a shade again. But that time, from the time it stops at the middle of the sky until it starts giving a shade, until it starts going west, that's about 10 minutes roughly. That's another time we're not supposed to pray or bury the dead. And then the last time, وَحِينَ تَتَضَيَّفُ الشَّمْسُ لِلْغُرُوبِ. And then the last moment, just before sunset. This is included in the prohibition of yesterday after Salat. So now the times of prohibition are how many? 5. 2 from yesterday, after Fajr, after Asr. And then you add to it, from sunrise until about 15 minutes after sunrise, until the sun is high up. And then from the noon time until it starts going towards the west, that's another 10 minutes. And then the last moment after, the last moment before sunset. And after Asr prayer was mentioned yesterday. So these 5 times, 2 of them are included in the other 2 times. So they say this nahi aam or nahi khas. So 2 of these times, اجتمع فيها nahi aam or nahi khas. This says إلا يوم الجمعة. It says except Friday. This is a weak narration. Except Friday, this is an addition that is weak. And why did they say? Some scholars say yes, Friday is an exception, even though the narration is weak. Why is that? Because of other hadith that indicate that the Sahaba used to come for Friday before noontime, maybe 10 or 11 a.m., and they used to pray whatever they like until the Imam comes in. So if this was a time of prohibition, they would have stopped praying. But actually, there's no strong indication that Friday is an exception. Because these Sahaba, some scholars say that you're not supposed to come in on Friday and then start reading Quran and then just when it's noon you start getting up and making a prayer. But if you're already in the masjid and doing prayers, you can continue doing that on the Friday. But you shouldn't just come in and maybe sit down a little bit, read Quran, then talk to someone, and then when you look at this noontime, then you start making a prayer. That is the prohibition. Because some other hadith prohibit, يعني لا تحرّوا الصلاة في هذه الأوقات. يعني do not deliberately pray at these times. So some other hadith indicate that the prohibition is to deliberately pray at these times. So So the exception of the Friday is not proven. Inshallah, I will stop here. The chapter still has a few hadiths left. Or maybe just a few, but some of them are few. Maybe tomorrow, inshallah, we'll try to finish. Inshallah.
Grace for the
Based on what? The hikmah from this is not clear about all the times. Why is it? But the after Asr prayer and after Fajr prayer is well known because there's other hadiths that indicate that people who worship the sun, they used to bow to the sun during that time, during sunrise and sunset. And also the hadiths, the Prophet ﷺ says, "In the shams tatlu wa taghrib bayna qarnay shaytan." وَذَلِكَ حِينَ يَسْجُدُ لَهَا عَابِدُوهَا. The sun rises and sets between the two horns of the shaytan. And that is when the people who worship it make sujood for it. So, and of course, shirk is the biggest prohibition in Islam. Shirk is the worst thing anyone can commit. So even the acts that may lead to shirk, or may look like you are committing shirk, are prohibited in Islam. So that is that includes the times of sunrise and the sunset. But what about the time of حِنَ يَقُمُ قَائِمُ الظَّهِيرَةِ? We don't know. Why is it prohibited at the time of the sun is in the middle of the sky? We do not know, but the other hadith indicate that the other times that we mentioned is because of the people who worship the sun. That's when they make the sujood for it. So what do we do if we go to the graves and it is about noon time? We wait until it starts going towards the west. Then we bury. Unless there is a necessity. Unless, for instance, it starts raining and we will not be able to finish and things are going to get messy. That's a different story. Is it allowed to bury during the night or no?
Yes.
It is allowed to bury during the night. There's a hadith of the woman that was buried. The woman who used to clean the masjid. She was buried at night. There is some hadith that mention a prohibition to bury at night. Why is that? Because Prophet ﷺ noticed that some of the Sahaba are not doing the proper ghusl and proper burial for at night time when he's sleeping. So he told them, no, wait until the morning before you bury, so that he teaches them how to do things. But there's indication that in the Sunnah that it was allowed to bury at night, and that the prohibition was because people were not doing things appropriately. Right? Now. Some scholars mention that the time of Jum'ah is not necessarily the time of Dhuhr. Some scholars mention that. And they say that the time of Jum'ah could even start before Dhuhr, before Dhuhr time. And so that's an opinion for some scholars. And some scholars mentioned that there's no prohibition on the day of Jumu'ah, even at the time of when the sun is in the middle of the sky at noon. But most scholars say no, the time of Jumu'ah is the time of Dhuhr, and it starts after Zawal. But you know, sometimes in the States, for instance, sometimes some people want to do it just before because of some reason, work or something, or school schedule, they can take that opinion of praying the Jumu'ah before Dhuhr time. Yeah.